Good afternoon, students. You are welcome to today's lesson on the subject technical drawing. The topic we are considering this afternoon is parabola. Parabola. At the end of the lesson, we'll be able to define a parabola. Two, we'll be able to explain a method of constructing parabola and how to construct parabola in a using rectangular method. A parabola is a locus of a point that moves in a plane so that its distance from a fixed point, that's the focus, on the plane is equal to the distance from a fixed straight line called directrice. This curve with red mark is a simple curve of a parabola. And so, from this definition, we can see that the distance P to Q is equal to FP. That's what we are saying here, that is FP is equal to PQ. This line is the directrice, and this line is the axis. And the point here is known as the vertex. So, the distance measured along this path to this point and this point, they are always equal. So we call it a parabola. And looking at the features of parabola, just like I said earlier on, this vertex, this axis, and this, you measure from this length to this length, we call this one span. And of course, the height, or in some place, we call it right. Some place, we call it right, or height. So the height of the parabola. Applications of parabola. Number one is used in construction of parabolic mirrors. You can use this in construction of parabolic mirror, like also water fountain. The water fountain is a sample of parabola. In quadratic equation graph in mathematics, so you have parabolic curve, which could be the negative form or the positive one. And also branch of physics called kinematics make use of parabola curve. And of course, in sports like javelins and discus. So when you throw a javelin, you follow a parabolic curve. These are some of the applications of parabola. Method of construction of parabola. We have the locus method, the rectangular method, and of course the envelope method. So this morning we want to quickly go through the rectangular method of constructing a parabola. Now, construction of parabola using a rectangular method. The first step is to draw a rectangle ABCD of a given dimension, AB height and BC standing for the span. That is, this length to this length will stand for the span, and AB, length A to B, will represent the height. So the first step, you draw the rectangle just like I've shown. The second step, you divide length AB and BC into four equal parts. If you want to use 5, then it will be 5 by 5. If you want to use 6, it will be 6 by 6. So, but for this one, I'm using 4 by 4. So, division of this point to 4, and division of this part to 5. Now, let's look at the next step. That's step 3. So, after division, you radiate lines from point. That's the point that we serve as the axis here. So, you have the point here, you have the point as you radiate the line from 0 to 1 to 2, both sides. Then you divide the vertical line, that's the axis. Radiate line from point O to 1 to 4 and parallel line through the axis. So we have the four lines, this 1, 2, 3, 4, and to the other side. Then from there, after that, the next thing, that's the last step to construct your parabola. You check the point of intersection of 1 to 1, 2 to 2. That's the vertical line intersecting with the radiated lines from 0. So all the points, the 3, and of course the 4. Then the other side, you check where this line 1, vertical line, intersect with this line. So you have 1. Then you have point 2, and of course, point 3, and point 4. So after that, you join it with a simple curve passing through the point to give you a simple parabola. So you have the point, joining the point of intersection of the radiated line and parallel line of the axis give you a parabolic curve. This is a simple method of constructing parabola using rectangular method. So we stop here for today. So when we get to our Google Classroom, we are going to talk more on other methods, and I wish you well. Bye for now.